What are the bones in the knee joint? Femur, tibia, no fibula, no, patella. Fibula does not have any direct role in the biomechanics of the knee joint. It is just for support. Just for support. Femur, tibia, patella. Three bones. It carries one mark. What are the distal femur condyles? How many condyles we are having?
Two.
We're having two condyles. Medial condyle, lateral condyle. Clear? Medial condyle, lateral condyle. Which condyle is larger? Your medial condyle is larger than lateral condyle. Please remember, your medial condyle is larger than the lateral condyle. And what is the use of these condyles? These condyles will contact the condyles of the tibia to form the tibiofemoral joint. Okay? Condyles of the femur are convex, condyles of the tibia are concave. So these both unite and they will form your tibiofemoral joint. Coming to the intercondylar groove. Where is your intercondylar groove? This one. So please remember, in the exam you have to show where is intercondylar groove, where is intercondylar notch. Intercondylar groove is present here between the two condyles, where your patella is resting here. Okay. Down one is intercondylar notch, where your cruciate ligaments are coming. Your intercondylar groove for patella. See like this. And your intercondylar notch for your cruciate ligaments. Then proximal tibia, tibial tuberosity. See, this is what I told you previously. When you go down to the patella and palpate, you can feel some bone, hard bond. Can you feel it? Just go just below the patella and place one finger.
Yes.
You can feel some very hard point. That is tibial tuberosity. So what is the significance of that one? Can you feel it? Hard one. What is the significance of that one is, your quadriceps tendon will come and attach here. Please tell, your quadriceps tendon will come here and attach in the tibial tuberosity. Okay? So carries one more. Coming to the joints, how many joints we are having? Two joints. Tibiofemoral joint, patellofemoral joint. In tibiofemoral joint, condyles of the femur are convex, condyles of the tibia are concave. Patellofemoral joint, patella is convex and femur is concave. Okay? Again, concave, convex also finish. Then, genu valgum normal angle. What is the genu valgum normal angle? 170 degrees. Please remember, 170 degrees genu valgum angle. Two things are there, excessive genu valgum, dyslex. If the person having knock knees, okay, the angle will be less. If the person having bow legs, the angle will be more than 170.
Sorry.
Okay, yeah, please remember here, excessive genu valgum means knock knees. Don't confuse here. Excessive means not more here. Excessive genu valgum means knock knees. Angle is less than 170. Genu varum means bow legs. Angle is more than 170 degrees. So please remember these three things here. Normal angle 170 degrees. Excessive genu valgum. Don't tell excessive means doctor more. No, wrong. It is less. Only in the knee joint. Knock knees. Less than 170. Bow legs more than 170 degrees. That is genu valgum. Coming to the motions, tibiofemoral joint. How many degrees of freedom we are having knee joint?
One.
2 degrees of freedom. Flexion, extension. Internal rotation, external rotation. Flexion, extension, sagittal plane, frontal axis.
Can you again?
2 degrees of freedom.
Yes.
Flexion, extension. Okay. Sagittal plane, frontal axis. Then internal rotation, external rotation. Horizontal plane, longitudinal axis. Now, femur on tibia, tibia on femur. Flexion, extension. When femur is moving on the tibia, roll and slide opposite direction. Please remember.
Because convex.
Convex on contact. When tibia is moving on femur, roll and slide
same
direction, because concave on convex. It may be flexion or extension, or it may be internal rotation or external rotation. Anything, it may be tibia on femur, femur on tibia. Concave on convex. Concave is here, tibia. Convex is femur, same direction. Convex on concave means femur moving on tibia. So roll and slide opposite direction. Coming to patellofemoral joint, what are the motions in patellofemoral joint? Sliding motions. Medial, lateral, anterior, posterior. There are some sliding motions. Now, at 135 degrees of flexion, 135 degrees of flexion, the superior pole is in contact with the femur. 90 degrees inferior pole, and 60 to 90
maximum
contact. Clear? At 135 degrees, superior pole is in contact, 90 degrees inferior pole, and 60 to 90 the contact is maximum. Clear? Then coming to the ligament injuries, applied anatomy. This you have to tell correctly. MCL, valgus injuries. Clear?
Yes.
Everyone, please.
Yes, yes.
LCL, varus injuries. Hyper extension,
ACL.
Hyper flexion,
PCL.
What about meniscus? How the meniscus will be injured?
By
sudden rotation. There is any rotation or twisting of the leg.
With fixed TV.
Yeah. When it is going for sudden twisting of the knee joint, your meniscus will be injured. Clear?
Yes.
Special test. What are the special tests? Anterior drawer test for ACL. Posterior drawer test for
PCL.
Can you please come once? Just. Again, I am showing you ACL, anterior drawer test. Patient will be in supine lying position. Okay?
90-90 flexion.
90-90. Hip 90 degrees flexion. Knee 90 degrees flexion. The therapist will be standing in front of the patient. Place the thumb over the tibial tuberosity. Fingers posterior side. Ask the patient to relax the quadriceps. Pull the tibia anterior. The patient complains pain or instability. Test is positive compared to the other side. For PCL, same patient will be in supine lying. 90-90. Place the thumbs over the tibial tuberosity and fingers posterior side. Push the tibia posteriorly. Okay? The patient complains pain or instability. Test is positive. This is PCL.
Yes.
Okay?
Yeah.
So, valgus test. Patient will be in supine lying. Okay? One hand at the superior aspect of the knee joint, other aspect at the other hand at the lower aspect. Okay? You will do valgus test. Means apply pressure from inside to outside here.
Literal
and here inside to outside.
Yes.
This is valgus. Valgus for test. Yes. And for LCL, varus test. Superior inside to outside. Inferior outside to inside.
No problem.
Why the degeneration inflammation of the joints will be there in the knee? People who are having ligament injuries, those are very risk of developing the osteoarthritis. And your upper body weight and your spine weight from the hip will go to the knee joint. So that's why people will develop osteoarthritis, means degeneration and inflammation in the joint articular surfaces. The joint space will be decreased, the bones will rub each other. Why? Means people who have ligament injuries, those are more risk of developing osteoarthritis in the life. Clear?